Hi, welcome to the Grease vlog. I'm so excited. I leave in like 5 minutes. I just finished the rest of my packing, getting my backpack together, my wallets, my passport, everything. I'm gonna walk to the train station because I didn't get my little outdoor walk-in today. Only issue, because I can't take the car. Only issue is it's raining, but it's okay. There's a saying in Germany that goes something like, we are not made of sugar. We will not melt in the rain. And I'm just gonna keep on telling myself that and telling myself that it's fine, even if it starts hailing again. So wish me luck. We're gonna go to the train station. I'm just gonna walk down to the train station. It's like a mile and a half walk, and then hop on the train and we're gonna go to Munich and then to the airport where we're staying the night. So see you in a sec. Okay, update. It's been about 5 minutes since I took that video. And the tornado sirens have gone off. And now there's this. Also, look how pretty the view is. Anyways, so I'm gonna get going. The mom said that it's fine. I like ran upstairs and I'm like, am I still okay to like walk a mile and a half in this? She's like, oh, you're fine. It happens all the time. Okay. Anyways, so that's gonna be a hazard. Okay, we're off. Oh, it's not scary. My mom would be very proud of me in this moment. I could walk with my hood up, and I'm actually really enjoying feeling the rain. I'm listening to some ABBA because, of course, gotta get in the mood. but this guy is just like, to the side of the road. Like, I'm walking on the left-hand side of the road, pulled up to where I was, rolled down his window, and he goes, do you know where you're going? Do you need a lift? Started talking to me in English with a German accent. So I guess I obviously look American. Just waving my arms around, walking in the rain with a big old grin on my face. Like, I'm just having the best evening. I'm just enjoying my walk a lot. But he was like, where are you going? Do you need a lift? And I was like, no, I'm good. And he was like, you have a lot of stuff. Are you leaving town? He was like, are you leaving town? Or something along the lines like, well, you're not from here. You're leaving town, yeah? And I was like, no, like, I live here. I'm going to Greece for a week. So I'm just walking to the train station. He was like, you have a lot of stuff, like you can just hop in. And I was like, he was very cute, I have to say. But also, I don't take rides from strangers. I listen to way too much true crime to do that. Yeah, that's like, no. And I was like, no, I'm actually really enjoying this. He was like, are you sure? I don't mind. And I was like, nope, I'm good. I got weird vibes. And I always trust my gut, but. It's actually quite nice, I have to say. I needed a good rain walk or some good music. I'm on top of the world. I'm going to freaking Greece. I don't need a ride from nobody. I'm taking this as a very good sign. This is... There's some very cute guys on the train who are gonna help me get to my next stop. I know how to get there, but they want to help me out, so I'm gonna help them do that. I don't even have to use the restroom, I just had to update the vlog. Those guys were so sweet, and they literally ended up walking me to the train, and then it was like another hour from Munich to the airport, and this is just me waiting on the train. Okay, first of all, we're gonna focus on the positives. Look how fucking sick this airport is. So freaking cool. Yeah, this is like the outdoor area. I think I'm gonna hang out here for a bit. It's currently, it's currently 11:35. Got off the second train, and I enter the airport and it's like ghost town, so empty. I'm like, this doesn't look promising. There's no one at the desk, there's no one at security. I don't know how I didn't put it together that I needed to get here earlier whenever it was still open. I thought all parts of all airports were 24 hours and not just like this part is 24 hours, but like security and stuff. So I can't get through because they have really nice lounges, and that's why I was like, I'd rather stay in a lounge than a hostel because it's free and it's like basically the same because it's just a room full of people you don't know and you have like one little small space. I'd rather do that for free, right? So I thought I'd be able to do that, but I can't even get to the lounges. And I talked to the guy, I was like, I need to sleep. Like, when does everything open? He was like, 3:30. So I have to be up at 3:30, so in 4 hours. I haven't had any dinner. So I'm gonna go get some freaking fries because that's the only thing I can eat from the only place open. But it's okay, we're gonna make the best of it. We really, really are. But hey, on the bright side, this is really, really sick. I like it a lot. I'm getting on that flight if it's the last thing I do. I don't care how many bumps I gotta run into. I'm getting on that flight.
They had like a couple chairs in the pre-security area, which I wasn't able to get from the pre-security past security because security and check-in was closed at this point. So they didn't have like hardly anywhere for people to wait, and a lot of people were sleeping there until security was open. And so I had to sleep on the cold, hard tile floors for 3 hours. And probably the worst sleep of my life, not gonna lie. I napped on the plane, literally from takeoff until landing, so that helped. But really, really awful situation. But I slept, and it was fine, and I figured it out, and I did wake up in time to get everything. But a little bit of a dramatic experience.
It is now 3:32 in the morning. We got our ticket. Oh my god, I'm so freaking tired. Now all we have to do, it was so easy. So easy. So now all we have to do is go through our security and hopefully sleep some more at the gate. But we load the board at 5:50.
It was a little bit chaotic, but after the flight we got on a shuttle bus, and the shuttle bus took us to the airport, and I waited outside of the airport for my driver for like half an hour in the pickup spot, and he didn't show up, and so I ended up paying 35 euros for a taxi. But I got here eventually, and then I had to go through check-in, and then eventually I figured out the building that I was staying in, which thank goodness I got the bottom building, which is literally right on the beach. Like my room is, I walk down the steps and I'm at the little beach club area, where they have like drinks and food, and just walk down some stairs and the beach is like right outside of my room. So that's really nice.
This hostel is freaking huge. I just had to go through like all the way up there. Down. Probably like half a mile. We're being dramatic. Oh my gosh, the beach is right there. This is crazy. Anyways, I just stumbled upon this deck. I've not even checked into my room yet. But I think I'm gonna go to the beach bar. I'm not really sure. But I'm gonna get settled in the room. Or I go to the beach. It's literally right there. But this seems like a fun place. I already made a friend. Her name is Mira. And we're gonna go to the, I think that's like beer pong and body painting party tonight. So we'll see. But I need to get changed and charge my Apple Watch. I thought I was staying in a giant room of like 12 people, because that's usually how it works. I got a friggin' too bad. I don't mean to be nosy, but the girl who's staying here seems cool. She has a cute backpack. This is the bathroom. Pretty cute. Leave my roommate a note. I'm not gonna be spending any time in here, not at all. I've literally been in here for 15 minutes just like unpacking. I shaved my legs because I did not do that before I left, and I'm sweating so much. But this is the fit. I'm gonna go up to the little beach bar and see if I can make some friends, or see if I can just like lounge around. I have my breakfast, my overnight oats, and I'm gonna see if I can just chill out. This is vacation, so I'm just gonna chill out. I'm gonna catch a little tan. The taxi driver, he was like, "Do you already have cream on?" And I was like, "No, like I literally just got off the plane. I don't have anything on." And he looks at me and goes, "You need to put some on." And I was like, "Oh, it's because I'm pale." And he goes, anyways, so excited.
I'm having a moment. I cannot believe that I'm here right now. Like, my hostel is literally right on the beach. Like, I can literally walk from my room 2 minutes and I'm just, like, not even, and I'm at the beach. Found this chair, chairs are free, I think. We'll see if somebody comes up to me. But I'm just gonna bask in the sun. I'm gonna finish up my book because I have, like, one more chapters left. I'm gonna sleep. Oh my God, I'm gonna sleep. Because I did not sleep at all last night. Like maybe 4 hours total, 4 or 5 total. I just took a little swim in the ocean and I have to say it feels freaking amazing. I forgot how much I love the beach, but we're just out here in Greece living my best life. And I made 2 more friends. They work here and they're like, "How long are you here for?" And I was like, 7 days. They're like, "Whoa." I was like, "Is that a long time?" They're like, "No, that's great. We'll see you around." So, and apparently they have parties every evening. So, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Happy Greece Mamma Mia summer, baby.
I'm regretting not bringing my tripod so much. So much. I spent like, I don't even know if I said this, but I spent 2 hours at the beach tanning. This is the dress that I just bought. Is it not the most me thing you've ever seen? I literally, I'm obsessed. I definitely got a lot of sun. I forgot to put on my sunscreen before I fell asleep because I was just so tired. So I got a little color. Got a little color going on. But I'm gonna go back down to the bar and talk with the cute guys that work here and try and get me some free drinks. I've been drinking on a Sex on the Beach and we're feeling good, we're feeling good. Can't get too crazy because we do have the cruise tomorrow.
Oh my gosh. I ended up making 2 friends down at the beach named Felix and Will. I'm so tired. I had like 4 drinks, I think. I had like a Sex on the Beach, 2 wines, and then another Sex on the Beach from the bar. But I got some major color. So I'm gonna take a nap and then we're all gonna meet up. Me, Felix, and Will are gonna meet up and go to the supermarket and get some drinks for tonight. And then I think we're gonna go to the beach club this evening. So we will see if I end up waking up on time because I do have my cruise in the morning at 8:45. So I'll see when I wake up.
My 2 friends are here and I'm going to see if they want to perhaps be in the vlog. We will see.
Oh, it's very cute, in case you were wondering. It's very cute.
But we're having a traditional dinner.
Hi, vlog!
I'm trying to make my vlog. You're not
fucking do this, man. Gosh. On God.
You know, I was like, oh my gosh, like it's so cool that I'm right next to the club and right next to the beach. It's so cool. Literally, you walk down the stairs and like the club is right there. You can hear it. But lucky for me, I am a deep sleeper. I wanted to show you guys. I have to put the phone on my roommate's bed, but I wanted to show you guys my little outfit for going out to dinner with the guys. And then we walked around Corfu for a bit and got ice cream and they got some waters. I got some headache medicine because not a lot of sleep and staying out in the sun all day, not a good combination. Oh, it's midday on top of that. It's probably not the best idea, but damn, I got so tan today. Yeah. It's fine. But oh, I'm so tired. But I think, even though I did take a 2-hour nap, but I think that I'm going to shower because I feel cranky. How the heck am I gonna do? If I'm getting in the ocean every day, I need to ask my mom if I need to be washing my hair every day, because I really don't want to wash my hair every day, but it's like, I don't want to have gross hair. But is the salt water good for it? Anyways, I have a major headache, so I'm gonna take at least a body shower, a very quick shower. I get up, PJs. Ah, and go to bed, but this is the end of day one. I don't know how I'm gonna edit these together. I may do like day by day, I'm not sure, because I'm sure they'll be kind of long. But then that would be seven vlogs. God, I'm gonna be here for so long. I was like, yeah, a week. That's so long. But the guys that I met tonight are here until the 5th, so. And I think we're gonna hang out tomorrow, so. Anyways, good night. See you in the morning at 6.
Look at the view from my hostel. Are you kidding? Absolutely the most beautiful place I've ever stayed. And it was only 22 friggin' euros a night. And I can't stop looking at this. I miss this.
Hello and good morning. It is the day of the cruise. I'm so excited. I need to put this somewhere. But I don't have anywhere to put it. Oh my gosh. Okay. I woke up at 5:20 this morning thinking that I was gonna go on a brisk walk. I'm just gonna stay here. Oh yeah. Thought I was gonna go on like a little brisk walk. I still need to put my shoes on. I was gonna do my hot cold contrast, you know, and then go jump in the ocean. Whenever I woke up, it was very dark outside. And I was like, maybe not. So I might do it one morning, because you're supposed to do it in like a fasted state, whatever. I might do it another morning whenever I don't have to be up and grooving so early. This is the shit. We got our headphones. It's like a 12-minute walk. I took a shuttle bus from Pink Palace to Corfu, like Corfu town. I'm like, okay, don't stare me on the port, and I figured out how to find the meeting place all by myself without any help. Oh my god! Made myself a little friend on the shuttle bus. Don't know why I'm talking like that. And they were two sisters from South Africa. So, and they're gonna be at La Grotta tomorrow. I look so tan. They're gonna be at La Grotta tomorrow. And I'm going to La Grotta tomorrow, so I think I'm probably going to see them there. But good morning.
I was actually really proud of myself for being able to figure out how to get to the Corfu port and being able to get to the meeting point on time despite not having any service. But I finally made it, got up to the top deck, and I actually ended up meeting these two girls who you'll see in a bit, but we ended up laying out on these beds. There was only 3 beds on the entire cruise ship, and we ended up laying out there and drinking and actually having the best day ever. But it was a gorgeous cruise ship. It really was. These are the girls. I love them. I miss you guys if you're seeing this. That's the Old Fortress. I didn't really get to hear a whole lot of the history that was going on because it was so loud. And she was speaking a lot of different languages. But, oh my gosh, those are the girls again. I miss them so much. So freaking beautiful. And look at that water. It literally looked like slushy water. It was unreal. It felt like I was in a dream. This is outside of Paxos. We finally docked. We went out to do a little bit of shopping with the girls. We got some produce. We went around and did a little bit of window shopping. And it was just so, so beautiful. The cutest little beach island town. And then we went on a little hike to go get some food, and I met some kitties. There were so many kitties around this island, like everywhere in Greece, and I was obsessed. We had some little friends for our lunch, and it had the most delicious lunch. We all shared some plates. This is a little seagull that joined us for our cruise. Very scared it was going to shit on my head. Cannot lie, but look how cute. So picturesque.
Go away.
Wait, let me see.
But how they did it.
This was around the time that we started making friends with a lot of the employees on board, a couple of the dancers. The captain ended up opening up our wine bottle with a little screw. Ugh, and then we went to the Blue Caves, which were just so, so, so beautiful, so unreal. And they played some really beautiful, like, meditative music when we were in the caves, and it was like a goddamn movie.
The hair is just a little rough.
It's beach hair.
It's beach hair.
No, let me see. No, they look good.
I didn't say darker.
They're not darker. It gives you a little facelift.
Okay.
I don't know how she did it, but Bella's DJing. I don't know how you did it. How did you do it?
I do me, you do you.
I do me and you do you. We love Bella.
Hi.
What?
She told us to get to say you hi.
Say hi? Yeah.
Yeah, hi. Hi.
She's going for it. She's killing it.
What was your last lead?
Cheers. Woo!
But I like it. Thank you.
Say hi.
Hello.
Appreciate it.
I look so tonic, you guys.
You all look super good.
Oh. I said so tall.
But I feel so sweaty.
I'm dressed. Okay. Thank you.
Sweaty.
No,
look like a giraffe.
We started that cruise around 8:45 that morning and only got back at like 7 p.m. And so we were absolutely exhausted and very, very hungry. And so we took a taxi to Bella and Cindy's Airbnb. Me and Bella ended up getting some food where we were joined by these cute little friends. They were adorable and we had the best service and the best company.
Here. I just took a shower. Oh my gosh. Put my moisturizer on. Used a pillowcase as my towel, but we're gonna take a very quick nap and then I think we're gonna hit the club. Not too bad. Shout out to the very nice girls who let me use their Airbnb. It's very cute. Shout out to them. Very, very, very nice people. They let me crash. Take a nap now and then we're gonna go to the club.
We ended up meeting with the girl's friend Kim, who ended up joining us to go out to the club for the evening. That's Kim. We stopped and got some ice cream and some drinks at this place called Bristello, I believe, and oh my gosh, it was delicious. There was ice cream on every corner, cute little supermarkets. It was just so beautiful. It felt like walking around in a fairy tale. Just like look at that view. loved it so much. We ended up stopping drinks around, I want to say, 1 or so in the morning, and then we caught a cab into 54 Dreamy Nights, which was a club that the girls and Kim wanted to go to for the evening. So this is just us in the taxi. And honestly, I had no idea where we were going, but I was just kind of along for the ride.
Yeah.
This is 54.
You don't stand in lines?
No.
She doesn't stand in lines.
You don't stand in lines here.
I don't.
I do me and you do you. Yeah.
Even in New York, I don't do lines. I've never been in a line.
In my life. A queue? Who's that?
Queue.
Don't know her.
In the middle queue? You queue? You queue? I have to guess? You mean a queue? I have to guess something?
Am I like in a curfew trivia?
I don't know how Bella managed to do it, but we in fact did not wait in that long ass line. She walked right up to the bouncer, showed him some photo of this guy that worked inside, claimed that she knew him. She did not know anyone there. And we had the rope lifted for us. We didn't have to pay any kind of fees or anything. And then she worked a little bit more magic and got us into the VIP area. They had these crazy light shows. We were getting free drinks. It was insane.
What's up, Dollar Fact? Boogie down Bronx. Word to my mother. Right here. We're not going anywhere.
Happy 4:30 in the morning. It's like 4:30 in the morning. Tony just got here tonight, but he acts like a local.
Yeah, I think we came here to party and bullshit. So.
Tony's from New York. Word. From the Bronx.
Boogie down.
We boogie down.
East Tremont and Webster Avenue.
Mm-hmm. Word. Mm-hmm. Word to your mother.
Were you here? Pull the trigger, pull the trigger, pull the trigger, boom!
Oh. 4:30 in the morning and we are on a mission to find fucking food. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, I feel like there's some
food. Oh, this is absolutely food. This is what's happening right now. Amazing.
What's going on over here?
Isn't this weird? It looks good.
But it's weird for us.
A little bit of cake, a little bit of ice cream. A little bit of bell. Mmm. Mmm. It's fantastic.
Bella and I ended up hailing a taxi around 6:30 or so in the morning, just in time to catch this beautiful, beautiful sunrise.
Oh my gosh, no voice, but I need my sunglasses. Oh, it's so freaking hot. Holy crap.
Around 10:30 in the morning, after only getting like 3 hours of sleep in the blazing heat, I started to move and embark on my journey to find a bus stop.
I have no idea where I am, but I'm walking to the green bus. Wait, literally. Sunrise. As we were taxi ride home. We were watching the sunrise. It was freaking ridiculous. And they got back to their place and I crashed on their couch for like 3 hours. And now I'm walking home. But I had the best night and I wanna go back. 54 dreamy nights is the move. Probably the best club I've ever been to. And that's saying a lot. Saying a fucking lot. Anyways, so beautiful. I will update you guys when I find the freaking bus stop. Wish me luck. I found a bus stop. It was like 5 minutes on the road. And I'm gonna ask if they know how to get back to my Airbnb. It's very well known and a lot of tourists say this Airbnb. I literally had a man come up to me last night, one of the workers there. He was so cute and old. And he was like, "You're staying at the Pink Palace, huh?" And I was like, "How do you know that? How do you?" And he goes, "You look it." Okay. So fucking hot. It's 10:30 and I'm sweating. It gets so hot so quickly. Like, I should have started finding a way home at 6. I really should have. So, what can you do? I gotta sleep on a couch for free. We'll love to play. So the next bus that goes back to where my hostel is, there's no buses on Sunday that go until 5:30 in the evening. It's currently 11:45. So he said, "I take you to the water and then you come back to the bus 5:15 and take you home 5:30. So unless I want to pay $35 for a taxi, I'm just gonna go to the water. No, well, I have a swimsuit, I have a towel, and I have a book. Okay. One in Greece, right?"
It was about a 45-minute bus ride down to these private beaches. I had no idea where I was going, but I was just like, you know, what's the worst that can happen? And oh my gosh, ended up being the best decision ever not to go home. I met the sweetest girls on the bus ride, and we ended up all going to this gorgeous private beach together and splitting some sunbeds. They got some drinks. It was one of their engagement, kind of bachelorette party type deals, and I ended up sleeping on these sunbeds like all day and getting some fruit, and I had a really good day. This is the DJ. The music was actually really, really good, and we had a good day. I finally got a ticket home. After I finally got back home to the hostel, I ended up meeting this group of girls that we all kind of came by ourselves. We ended up all getting dinner together, and they were the sweetest, and I enjoyed this group so much. And this was the night that I met Anna and a banana, a new bestie. It was so beautiful, such good food, oh God, such good vibes, good people.
For the vlog. This is my bitch, Anna.
Hi.
Anna and I are soulmates, and you can't tell me that
we're soulmates.
We're soulmates. She's a Sag. I'm a Gemini.
We met just today.
Literally, probably an hour and a half ago. We are like this. So Kaylee and I just met this evening.
Yes. And I was like, I know this girl. She has a familiar face. And then familiar. I said something. She was like, "I know you." Turns out we dated the same girl in high school.
Yes,
she's
did.
From Toronto. I'm from Denton. Absolutely insane. You know, men bring women together. Shitty men.
As they should.
Bring women together. Fuck Drew. That's all I'm gonna say. I love it. I love it. I might break
not
my
before
egg.
Before we get to Lemon Tree, okay?
I almost got ran over by a motorcycle, and Anna saved my life. Thanks, God! Oh. Coming home last day from Christmas Eve.
What time are we meeting up at to go home?
I don't know. I'll find you guys.
We're going to be with each other.
We're glowing.
We're glowing.
We're glowing.
You can't see it, but it's happening.
Just know from the inside out, we're glowing. We're glowing.
It's happening.
Anna.
I ended up meeting
this group of guys, which actually like 3/4 of the group actually worked at the hostel that we were staying at. So it was really good that we met them, because then we kind of knew some people that worked there, which was really good. We challenged them in a game of pool and we lost miserably, but we still got free drinks, so it was fine. Anna and I ended up meeting some waiters that we met earlier. I met the waiter that we had from dinner, and she met this beautiful, beautiful Greek man named Stelios that she met at lunch that day. And I ended up going on a beautiful walk with Chris, my waiter, and then she ended up going on a motorcycle ride with Stelios, and the other girls met some other guys that ended up taking them on their motorcycles. We had a really great night overall. This is the end of part one. There will be a part two of everything else that happened, because Anna and I began our trip together, and I actually ended up extending my stay because of Anna, and definitely met a lifelong friend that night and some other lifelong friends. But this is the end of part one. It gets a lot crazier in part two. I'm gonna try and edit it and upload it within the next like day or so, but it's a lot of footage. We had a lot of fun. Definitely the best week of my entire life. I am back home safe and sound, so I'm gonna go ahead and upload this. I'm gonna go ahead and head to the gym now, because I did not go to gym this entire week. So this is the end. I hope you enjoyed it, and be looking for a part two. Live, love, Greece.